Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss Coulomb's law. In previous classes, you have studied that like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. Now, the force of attraction between unlike charges or the force of repulsion between the like charges can be calculated using Coulomb's law. So, Coulomb's law gives us a formula, a mathematical formula, using which we can calculate the electric force acting between two point charges which are at rest. The statement of Coulomb's law is, the electric force between two point charges is directly proportional to the product of magnitude of charges and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Further, this force acts along the line joining the two charges. Suppose we have two charges, Q1 and Q2. These two are point charges. These two charges are at rest. The distance between these two charges is R, and the charges are placed in vacuum or free space or in air. In physics, vacuum, free space, air, all are equivalent. So we have two point charges Q1 and Q2, which are static, which are at rest, at a separation of R and placed in vacuum. There is no medium between these two charges. Suppose the electric force acting between these two charges is F. This electric force may be attractive, may be repulsive, that depends on the nature of charges. If the two charges are of like nature, electric force will be repulsive. But if the two charges are of unlike charges, then the electric force between them will be attractive. So F is simply the magnitude of electric force acting between two charges. Then, according to statement or definition of Coulomb's law, electric force is directly proportional to product of magnitudes of charges. Magnitude of charges means we have to consider charges without their mathematical sign. And this electric force is inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. This is often known as inverse square law. When we combine these two, we get F varies as Q1 Q2 divided by R square. If we want to replace this proportionality with equality, then we need to introduce a constant. Here the constant is K. So the equation becomes F equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square. This is equation 1. Now, this constant K, the value of constant K depends on two factors. First is nature of medium between the two charges, and second is in which system of units we are working. The medium between the two charges is fixed here. It's vacuum, free space, or air. So this K will depend only on the system of units in which we are interested. In SI, K has value 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So if we put the value of K in equation 1, the formula for force becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by R square, and this is the final formula that we will use to calculate electric force acting between two point charges. Now, epsilon naught in the formula, it's a constant. Its name is permittivity of free space. It is known as permittivity of free space, and it has a fixed value. That value is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 coulomb square per newton per meter square. Now let us calculate the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Putting the values of pi and epsilon naught in the expression, if we solve this, we get 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So the final formula for the calculation of force is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square, and the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. It is very important to keep in mind that the formula that was studied here as equation 2 for the calculation of magnitude of electric force, this formula is applicable only in case when charges are placed in vacuum or in free space or in air. If the medium between the charges is something other than vacuum, is something other than free space, is something other than air, in that very case, we cannot use this equation there to calculate the magnitude of electric force. Now, look at this situation. Again, we have two charges, Q1, Q2, placed at a separation of R, but this time, medium is something other than vacuum or air. So if charges are placed in a medium other than air or vacuum or free space, in that very case, the formula for calculation of electric force becomes F equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into K. This K is capital K into Q1 Q2 by R square. So equation number 3 and equation number 2 are the final formulae for the calculation of electric force. Equation 3 is applicable when charges are placed in a medium other than vacuum, other than air, other than free space, whereas equation 2 is used in case when charges are placed in vacuum or free space or in air. K is called dielectric constant of material of medium between the two charges. Now in electrostatics, we have two K's. One is small k, other is capital K. These two have entirely different meanings when we are discussing electrostatics. Small k means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught having a fixed value 9 into 10 to the power 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. Whereas capital K in electrostatic represents a constant which is called dielectric constant of medium. It is unitless as well as dimensionless. It can never be less than 1. It can never be less than 1. It means it is either equal to 1 or more than 1. For air, K is equal to 1, and for all other remaining media, K is more than 1. Now, one important point is here. While using the formula for calculation of electric force, it should be kept in mind that all known values should be put in SI. Then the unknown quantity will come out in SI.